Hey everyone, Kelsey here from Premiere Gal, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make it look like your footage is playing from a VHS tape. Let's get into it. All right, so first things first, let's create an adjustment layer. And let's drag it on top of our clip on video layer 2 in the timeline. This clip here is a free clip from Adobe Stock. If you want to follow along, you can download it below. So now we need to add distortion and stylization effects to this adjustment layer that will be applied to the video clip below. First, go to Effects and search for Emboss and double-click to apply it to our adjustment layer. So as you see here, the Emboss effect essentially sharpens the edges of the objects in the video and suppresses the colors. So to show you how this works, let's zoom into our program monitor so you can see how the effect controls work. First, we don't want too much suppression of the color, so let's increase the blend with original to around 80. Next, we need to play around with the relief slider. The relief is kind of like the height of the embossing, so it controls the width of the edges. So as you increase, this gets bigger. I'm going to set mine to around 4. Then let's make more contrast around the edges using the contrast slider. I'll set mine to around 300. So now this is the before, and here's the after. So it's starting to look more retro already, but we still have some more to do. Next, let's go to Effects and search for the effect called Noise, and double-click to apply it to our clip. And here we can adjust the amount until it looks right. I'll adjust mine to around 10%. So we have the embossing, we have the noise, and now we need to use the Lumetri color panel to make some adjustments to the brightness, the shadows, as well as some color adjustments so it looks more washed out and retro. First, let's reduce the exposure just a little bit, maybe around 0.5, minus 0.5 is good, very subtle. And then we're going to reduce the contrast a bit, so that way it looks a little bit more washed out. And then we can take away some of the darkness in the shadows by increasing the shadow slider to around 30, 35. I think that looks good. So now when we turn Lumetri color off and then on, you can really see that it's starting to look more washed out and old. Next, we can add some color distortion from Lumetri. So go down to the curve section and go to RGB curves. And let's select this red color here because the red is the primary color in this video. And let's bring down the top corner line of this red. And as we do that, you can see that the red color becomes more washed out and makes it look more distorted. So the color is looking good, starting to look old, but now we need to add a little bit more blur because this footage was shot in 4K and we don't want it to be as sharp. So let's go to Effects and search for Directional Blur, and then double click to apply it to the adjustment layer. Next, from the effect controls, let's set the blur length to around 4. And to add icing on the cake, we want to add the scan lines. So you know those lines that you see on old videotapes. Now, Premiere Pro doesn't have a built-in scan lines effect, but you can create your own horizontal lines stacked on top of each other in Photoshop, or you can get a scan line graphic from Adobe Stock. So I already have my scanline graphic and I've already imported it into my project panel. So what I'm going to do is move the adjustment layer up to video layer 3 and then place the scanline graphic on top of the footage just beneath the adjustment layer. So that way all of the effects are being applied to the scan lines as well. And you can see it looks a little bit too harsh. So from effect controls, let's actually lower the opacity of the scan lines down to about 10%. And now we're going to create the little classic play text in the corner. Press T on your keyboard to create text and type out the word play on the program monitor. I'm going to select OCRA, which is a part of Adobe Fonts, and then I'll position this to the upper left corner. Also, be sure to move the text layer below the adjustment layer, so that way all those cool effects are also applied to the text layer. And then press return to render it all out so you can see the full res preview. So what are you waiting for? Go out there and start creating this really cool VHS effect in your own videos now that you know how it works. And if you want to learn more tips from the series, just go down there and click the little playlist link and you can watch more. That's all. Thanks for watching. Bye.